I'm Rachel Lee. I'm a graduate student in the physics department in Wolfgang Losert's lab, and I'm studying how cancer cells move.
That is exciting.
So we take movies of healthy cells and cancer cells moving, and then we use various image analysis techniques to measure their motion, and then apply tools from my physics background to understand how the healthy and cancer cells move differently. So my daily work involves keeping cells alive, which requires, for me, because I work with human cells, an incubator that's kept at human body temperature. I need to work in a hood that is sterile, and I also use a very nice microscope that allows us to take time-lapse movies of these cells that also has some temperature control equipment. There was a learning curve, especially keeping cells alive requires that you keep your workspace sterile, which is not something I'd had to do before, but after practice, you sort of get the hang of it. I am from all over. I was born in Texas, but my family moved about every 3 or 4 years, and I ended up doing my undergraduate at the University of Arkansas before moving out here to Maryland, so I've been around. I always wanted to do science. I wasn't really sure what field. I've bounced around a lot between the different fields of science. In high school, I think my favorite class was probably chemistry. I enjoyed that quite a bit. I didn't really know that much about physics yet until I got to college, but I started out in undergraduate studying chemical engineering, and I was pretty into traditional chemical engineering, and then I thought for a while about studying fusion or maybe superconductors, and ended up meeting my advisor here who convinced me to join this cancer project that I really like. For me, with the background in engineering and physics, I didn't actually know a lot of the biology, but the researchers at the National Institutes of Health have been really great about answering my questions and teaching me a lot of biology. We're lucky to be so close to the National Institutes of Health in that they were really excited to have me teach them physics, and in return they were really happy to teach me some biology. Science is always challenging because if we already knew the answer, we wouldn't be doing this, and every day there's something where we didn't realize that it was going to work that way and we have to take a right turn and try a new experiment. I think just the data itself, I'm lucky that my data is these nice time-lapse movies of cells moving, and watching them every day, they surprise me how they move. There's so many things going on in that movie and I just want to understand why they're doing that. So in the future, we're really hoping to start pinning down some details about very specific differences between the healthy and cancer cells, and I think that'd be very exciting to be able to find those little unknown pieces and work on them.